So for the last presentation of the day, the speakers are the graduate students Aslı Nur Yaltı and Nazlı Hilal Başkurt. And now I will briefly read their biographies. Aslı Nur Yaltı completed her undergraduate education at the Department of Turkish Language and Literature at Balıkesir University. In addition, she is studying for a second bachelor's degree at the Department of Social Services of Eskişehir University, but is doing a master's degree in the field of New Turkish Literature and Department of Turkish Language and Literature of Balıkesir University. Nazlı Hilal Başkurt started her undergraduate education in the Department of Elementary Mathematics teaching at Artvin Çoruh University. Then she transferred to Trakya University. In addition to mathematics, she has accumulated certificates for her interest in photography. She is currently pursuing her master's degree in elementary mathematics education at Balıkesir University. The fact that there is not much research on semiotics in the numerical field in Turkey has caused her interest to shift in this direction. So she continues her studies on this subject. And now I leave the floor to Aslı Nur Yaltı and Nazlı Hilal Başkurt to make their presentation titled Modernization Process of Turkish Painting from Miniature to Modern Painting, Osman Hamdi Bey.
Hello.
Hello, you can start your presentation.
Yes. The Modernization Process of Turkish Painting from Miniature to Modern Painting, Osman Hamdi Bey. Hello, dear participants. I'm Nazlı Hilal Başkurt. Today, together with Aslı Nur Yaltı, we will give you information about the historical development of miniature art and Osman Hamdi Bey. First of all, I will talk about the historical development of miniature art and its transformation into modern painting and the representatives of a field. Afterwards, my friend Aslı Nur Yaltı will give you information about the life and works of Osman Hamdi Bey. One of the important about the life, one of the important representatives of the art of painting. Thank you all in advance. The history of miniature. Miniature is a term used for painting made with watercolors and to decorate manuscript books. It is taken from the Italian word miniatura. In the Turkish word, since ancient times, miniature has been called embroidery and the embroiderer has been called nakkaş. In Turkey, embroidery is a term used in the sense of painting with paint. Those who paint with paint are called nakkaş. Those who paint paintings and people are called musavir or şebi. Those who paint landscapes and tezinat are called tara. Miniature technique, arranging the figures in such a way that they do not cover each other, driving the remaining figures on the upper side of the paper, determining the size of the people according to their importance, not specifying the distance in the landscape in terms of color and height ratio, processing even the finest details, applying colors without looking for light and shadow effects, are the unique features of miniature. For miniature, paper made of cotton and colored Indian paper, silk paper, colored parchment, and paper with a colored paper were used. The brushes used to apply paints in miniature are made from the nail hair of the 3 months old white cat. Painting and miniature arts. Sorry. Yes. Painting and miniature art in Turks and its historical development. The history of painting and miniature art among Turk states back to the times when they appeared on the stage of history in Central Asia. Since the second half of the 19th century, archaeologists and historians have been conducting excavation and researches in Central Asia, the homeland of the Turks, and have as a result demonstrated that painting and miniature is a Central Asian Turkish art. The Uyghurs played a major role in the spread of painting, miniature and sculpture to the Islamic world. After the Uyghurs, the Seljuks, and later the Ottoman were interested in miniature. Miniature in Ottoman. The development of Ottoman miniature art is defined in six phases. Phase one, the formation phase covers the period between 1451 and 1520, starting with Mehmed II and ending with the reigns of Bayezid II and Selim I. Phase two, the transition phase covers the period between 1520 and 1574, during the reign of Süleyman I and Selim II. Phase 3, classical phase, the period of Murat III and Mehmed III, covers the years 1574-1603. Phase 4, late classical and stagnation phase, covers the years 1603-1700. Fifth phase, the period between 1700-1750, which covers the reign of Ahmed III and the first half of the 18th century. Sixth phase, the last phase, covers the years 1750-1900. After 1750 is considered as the end of the Ottoman miniature. Important miniaturists in Ottoman, Nakkaş Hasan Paşa. The characters he draws are fat, with thick short necks, full faces, thick black eyebrows, and birds with straight cut ends. Trees with long trunks and sharp heels cutting each other constitute the elements of nature. Orange, red, fruze, yellow, and red-brown used in interior floors are the main elements of his style. The predominance of a relaxing and naturalistic taste in color instead of striking bright tones, the harmonious presentation of even contrasting tones and the abundance of the extensive use of gilding can be counted among his technical characteristics. In Leibniz miniatures, it is seen that the classical understanding of order has changed, and in the paintings with crowded groups, there is a tendency towards depth as opposite to the usual miniature perspective. Matrakçı Nasuh, in addition to his works on mathematics and history, he is also famous for his miniatures. Matrakçı Nasuh has a unique style that is mixture or miniature and map. In his works, he depicts a bird's eye view of the earth. On the other hand, he draws the shapes not from above, but as if he was seeing them from the opposite side. Although there are animals such as birds and rabbits in this painting, people are never visible, but the buildings in the cities can be selected one by one. This was later known as the Matrakçı style in Ottoman miniature art. Şahkulu, he was the sarnekkaşı of the palace embroidery house of the reign of Süleyman the Magnificent and the first representative of Saz patch decoration style. Behzat is known for being gifted. There are many scholars who say that his artistic talent was not of a kind that is always encountered, that his miraculous art affected the whole art of depiction, that his brush gave life to lifeless shapes. Abdullahi Buhari, he is the most well-known of the last depiction artists who grew up during the transition from the traditional miniature style to Western painting. In his depiction, especially in the treatment of the faces of figures, it is seen that he tried to give them a dimension with Western influence. Thank you for listening to me. Now I will give the floor to my friend Aslı.
From Miniature to Modern Painting, the Modernization Process of Turkish Painting by Osman Hamdi Bey. Introduction. Osman Hamdi Bey, who lived in the 9th century.
I'm sorry for interrupting. Please share your PowerPoint presentation. We cannot see the topic.
Sorry. From Miniature to Modern Painting, the Modernization Process of Turkish Painting by Osman Hamdi Bey. Introduction. Osman Hamdi Bey, who lived in the 9th century and painted his paintings in the second half of the century, is accepted by Turkish art historians as the pioneer of modern Turkish painting. Today, the most valuable paintings of Turkish painting and sculpture museums, especially the Ankara Painting and Sculpture Museum, were painted by Osman Hamdi Bey. Osman Hamdi is also Turkey's first archaeologist and first museologist. In this respect, Osman Hamdi is a pioneer, named not only on terms of painting, but also in museum studies and archaeological research. His paintings constitute an important stage in the transition from classical Turkish miniature art to modern painting. In my presentation, I will first give information about Osman Hamdi Bey's biography and his works. Later, I will examine Osman Hamdi Bey's most famous paintings, especially the Turtle Trainer, in terms of passing scenes and icons. Osman Hamdi Bey. Osman Hamdi Bey was born in Istanbul on 30 December 842. His father was İbrahim Ethem Paşa and his older brother was İsmail Gayrı. He grew up as a versatile personality with the support of his family. In 1857, his father İbrahim Paşa sent him to Paris to study law. However, he abandoned his law education due to his interest in painting. He turned towards art. He studied painting at the Paris High School of Fine Arts. He worked in the workshops of Jean Lengarme and Gustave Boulanger, who were well-known painters of the period. After 12 years in France, he returned to Istanbul. After returning to Turkey, Osman Hamdi Bey was appointed director of the Museum Humayun. He deepens his works in the field of culture and art. A brand new era began in Turkish museology. The Museum Humayun was transformed into the Istanbul Archaeological Museum through Osman Hamdi's efforts. Osman Hamdi Bey carried out the first excavations by Turks. He personally directed the excavations of Mount Nemrut, Saida, and Lagina. Osman Hamdi Bey and art. Another important aspect of Osman Hamdi is his painting. Osman Hamdi's working technique and style are different from his contemporary Turkish painters. His paintings are close orientalist in terms of style. The influence of his teachers, especially Gerom, can be seen. Unlike Western painters, he reflected the beauties of the East and Turkish art with his admiration for Selçuk and Ottoman culture. In Turkish painting, compositions with human figures and large-sized figures are first seen in Osman Hamdi's works. There is always a human figure in the architecture he painted. He successfully placed his figures inside the space in front of magnificent architectural and ornamental elements. The artist used photographs of himself, his family, and the people around him in his works. For this reason, he is known as the first portrait painter in Turkish painting. He is also the first artist to deal with the subject of women in Turkish painting. He portrayed women in equal position with men in daily life. He portrayed the figures as self-confident, upright, thinking and wearing clothes suitable for their environment. Elbise Osmaniye, which he sent to the Viyana exhibition, had a great influence on his portrayal of different clothes. He emphasized architectural elements in his paintings. He attracted attention with his fine and detailed workmanship in his paintings. He painted the objects and places he's painted exactly as they were in reality. He painted the doors of tombs and masks, the writings on them, wood and stone carvings, tile decorations, calligraphy, fabrics, steamboats, candlesticks, oil lamps, swords and weapons with great observation and meticulous technique. He mostly utilized photography in his paintings. He produced works in the assembled style. Considering the connotations of the Turkish art of painting at the time, Osman Hamdi, who is considered one of the most successful painters, he approximately 200 now works. Some of his paintings are as follows: Mihrab, the tortoise trainer, two young girls visiting, two musician girls, girl with pink cup. One of Osman Hamdi Bey's famous paintings is The Tortoise Trainer. It is Osman Hamdi Bey's self-portrait and there are various symbols in the painting. Some of these symbols are as follows. Turtle, it is a slow and cumbersome animal and difficult to train. The turtles are reflect the segments of Ottoman society that resist westernization. The trainer is the figure who tries to train the inept turtles. The window is symbolized as an evolved westernization, the point to be reached on the white modernization. The mask is the religious symbol of the country in which it is located. It is one of the cultural symbols of the Ottoman Empire. Ney is an instrument. It is one of the tall symbolizing art. It emphasizes that art. That art has a very important place in the path of westernization and modernization. Thai is one of the local riches and cultural heritage of the Ottoman Empire. By using these elements, the artist expresses the cultural diversity of his society by flourishing the East. The painting is enriched with symbolic expressions. For the tortoise trainer, it has been interpreted that the artist identified state institutions with tortoises. Likewise, it has been interpreted that the turtles symbols the extremely slow Ottoman bureaucracy and that Osman Hamdi Bey struggles at this point with the patience of a dervish. The only toll in the hands of the turtle trainer, which Osman Hamdi Bey identifies with himself, is art symbolized by the musical instruments in the painting. It is estimated that the skin takes place in the green mosque in Bursa. In this painting, Osman Hamdi depicted a dervish as can be understood from the meaningful look in the portrait. During Osman Hamdi Bey's westernization efforts, state institutions and society constantly created new obstacles and resisted change. The turtles in the painting represent the cumbersome bureaucracy of the state and the people who resist change. Two Musician Girls is one of Osman Hamdi's most important works. The place in the paintings is the burial hall of Bursa Green Mosque. At the entrance of the section, there are two young girls playing dead and tambur, two of our traditional instruments. The painting in question represents the talented Ottoman woman with two girls in two different positions. As the general style of Osman Hamdi Bey's works, female figures with various talents and strong personalities played an important role during the westernization period. For this reason, we see women playing instruments and reading books in his works, including these paintings. In this painting, Osman Hamdi Bey depicts himself reading the Quran. In this painting, the artist has placed the entrance of the mosque in a position where it is not normally found. There are two prominent inscriptions just above the person reading the Quran in what appears to be an oval on the left entrance. The first of these is the yellow inscription, "He is merciful and forgiving." which the artist also used in some of his other paintings, and the second is the inscription, "Even if the mountains crumble and the heavens split." Although this inscription is in Arabic, it is actually the last line of a Persian poem praising the green mask. Osman Hamdi Bey's painting Carpet Seller depicts a carpet with animal motifs from the Eastern Anatolia region. In addition to animal motifs, motifs such as leaves, flowers, and roses are placed on the edges. It can be said that the carpet hanging on the wall is Anatolian Yörük carpet from the 19th century, while the carpet in the seller's hand is a Caucasian carpet from the 19th century. There are repeating motifs, bird motifs, Tennessee cars, zigzag format, by small triangles and 2D borders in blue. Conclusion. Modern Turkish painting began in the second half of the 19th century. Its most important founder is Osman Hamdi Bey. It is almost impossible to talk about the art of painting in the Ottoman period. We can attribute the absence of painting Ottoman society to the propagation of painting by Islam. Instead of painting, miniatures are developed in Ottoman culture. There is no subject-object semblance in miniature art. There is no proportion. The principle of closeness in style is essential. This shows that Ottoman miniature art was under the influence of ancient Egyptian and Indian art. Osman Hamdi expressed the world perception of the Ottoman Turkish society through his paintings. The difference of Osman Hamdi Bey's paintings from the classical Ottoman miniature tradition is that the abandoned the disproportion, closeness, and ambiguity of the classical miniature. Instead, he brought to Turkey a new understanding of painting in which what is said and what is intended to be told are in harmony. Thus, the classical Ottoman miniature art was replicated by the development of a more worldly modern art of painting.